Well, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
If everybody could go ahead and move into their seats, we'll go ahead and get this event started. I want to welcome everyone here this morning to the Tigg Farm, beautiful southern Alamance County. So glad to have all of you here with us today. I'm Brian Haygood. I currently have the privilege of serving as Alamance County Manager. See a lot of familiar faces here in the crowd, and it's good to see all of you, and welcome to each one of you. We've got a lot of important community agricultural leaders with us here today that have helped make programs like the new Preserve Alamance possible. Elected officials, ag community leaders, you're going to hear from a number of these folks today. We're just so glad to have y'all with us. We're here today to celebrate the rollout of the newest tool in Alamance County's toolbox to help preserve farmland in our county, Preserve Alamance. And we're very excited about this new program. Been a lot of collaboration between commissioners and the ag community and our agricultural departments to put this together. And I would tell you that this is right in line with Alamance County's strategic plan. The county went through a process a number of years ago to identify important functions of county government for Alamance County. And the number one pillar identified during that process was preserving agriculture. And I'll just tell you that it was really clear as we went through that process that we have a strong agricultural community in our county, strong agricultural economy here, and it was communicated very well to the commissioners and to the staff that part of the county's role should be to create a culture in Alamance County that values agriculture and supports our local farming community. So we're glad to have all of you here. We're glad to have our county commissioners here. We have a number of commissioners. I'm going to attempt to introduce the elected officials that I know are here today. And some of them you'll be hearing from in just a moment. I know that we have Senator Amy Gailey from District 24 with us today. Glad to have you here, Senator. We also have the Commissioner of Agriculture, Mr. Steve Troxler. Great to have you here with us, Commissioner. We have several county commissioners with us today. We have our board chair, John Paisley. You'll be hearing from him in just a moment. We also have Commissioner Pam Thompson with us here on the front row, and Commissioner Bill Lashley is also with us today. I know we had invited several other folks to be here. Elected officials, if I'm missing you, please speak up or stand up or don't hesitate. Sun's in my eyes a little bit, so I don't want to pass anybody over. We do have Mr. Sam Shoemate here also with us from Representative Ted Budd's office. Very glad to have Sam with us. He's been a big supporter of county government and our ag community too. So, looking out amongst the crowd, I see no hands going up. I must have gotten everybody, so that's fantastic. But at this point in the program, I'd like to take just a moment and introduce a very important gentleman that's been a key part of this Preserve Alamance formulation and rollout, Mr. Frank Bell. Frank's a longtime Alamance County resident. For those of you who don't know Frank, I can't imagine there's anybody here that don't know Frank in some capacity. He has given his life to serving the residents and the citizens of Alamance County. He's been very active and a key member of Alamance County Cattlemen's Association. He's also been a key part of our Board of Equalization and Review and served a very important function with that body, as well as involvement with the Agricultural Advisory and the Farmland Preservation Board. And Frank has worked tirelessly to help put together this program that we're rolling out here today. So with no further ado, I'd like to introduce Mr. Frank Bell.
Thank you, Brian. First thing I want to do is thank the Lord for a beautiful morning. Amen. Father, we thank thee for this day that you have so graciously given us. We thank you for all of your blessings. And Father, we thank thee most of all for giving us one of the greatest assets in the world today, and that's land. Help us, Lord, as we gather together today, that the intent of this program will be successful in this county and hopefully throughout this state. Bless us today, for it's in thy name we pray. Amen. It gives me great pleasure in introducing our host today to a family that are, their roots are right here. They were born down the road several years ago in Snow County and migrated to here. There are no strangers to agriculture. They've been in agriculture for many, many years. The people who has got the responsibility for keeping this facility as you see it this morning is Randy Tigg. We talked about Junior a few minutes ago, and I, you know, when you get old, your memory goes from you. But Randy Tigg, Randy's right here. His wife Diane, and his helper Tim Thompson. Those people are in the trenches and get it done daily. We thank you for your participation. We thank you for your invitation. Behind these people is a man that I've got a lot of respect for. Tommy Tigg is one of the most successful entrepreneurs that I know. He is the president and CEO of Salem Leasing. They own farms in Iowa. They have deer and cattle. They own farms in Texas. They raise deer and cattle. And it's about 900 acres here in Alamance County and joining Chatham County that they're responsible for. I want you to put your hands together and thank these people for giving us the opportunity to come here today and to share a program that I think you'll be well achieved. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Frank. And at this point in our program, we'll receive a welcome from Chairman John Paisley, the chair of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners. Chairman Paisley, longtime attorney in Graham and Alamance County, and some of you may not know, he's also an avid hot air balloon pilot, and I'm sure this would be wonderful weather for flying today. And Chairman Paisley has also served with various boards across the county, the Board of Elections, our local mental health authority, ACTA, and he is currently the liaison to the Alamance County Planning Board, so he has a good understanding and appreciation for farmland preservation. So no further ado, welcome Chair John Paisley.
Good morning. Welcome from Alamance County. I think most of you are from Alamance County, and Commissioner Tigg is just barely over the county line in Guilford, so we're claiming that he's part of Alamance County as well. So we appreciate you being here. Our state senator, a number of dignitaries are here, and we welcome everyone, but particularly the Tiggs. We really appreciate what you have done, what you are continuing to do for all of the country and Alamance County. We just want to say thank you. I grew up on a tobacco farm in McLeansville, as Steve Troxler did, just barely over the county line. I can really appreciate what's going on here. The farm that we grew up on, the primary farm was about 110 acres, and the secondary farm was only about 100 acres. And so I saw a lot of tobacco. I can always tell, people walk up to me, oh yeah, I grew up on a tobacco farm, and they start talking about priming tobacco in t-shirts, and I know they're lying. So anybody that grew prime tobacco, you know you didn't wear short sleeve shirts. But the good thing is we always snuck one or two or three or four watermelons down in the creek in about mid-afternoon. Guess what? Back with the tobacco sleds, went a couple of the watermelons back to the barn where they were stringing and so forth, and a couple of them might have stayed out in the field. This preservation program is absolutely astounding and wonderful. I truly appreciate everything that this group is doing. It's preserving not just farmland, but our entire county. Flying hot air balloons, and by the way, I don't disturb any of your livestock. So being honest about cattle and hot air balloons, we have a whisper burner, and that's what it's called. So if we're flying over livestock, we can shift to that secondary burner and should not be disturbing your livestock. But having grown up on a farm, believe me, I'm not going to bother your livestock because that's money. It's like the tobacco stalks. When the mule got excited and the sled was getting heavy and it wanted to cut the corners, oh, that didn't last long. Dad sold the mules. So again, the preservation program is absolutely astounding. I just want to say thank you to all you folks. Thank you.
So now to give us an overview of the Preservation Alamance program, I'd like to introduce Mr. Brad Moore. Brad's the District Conservation Administrator for the Alamance Soil and Water Conservation District. Glad to have him with us. And Brad has been an integral part of putting together the Preservation Alamance program and will be a key component in implementing it too. So we're glad to have Brad here today and ask Brad to give us a little bit of an idea of what the program's about. So.
Thank you, Brian. For more than two decades, Alamance County has been a leader in farmland preservation. Starting in the early 2000s, the Voluntary Agricultural District was formed to bring awareness to our urban neighbors that they were moving into an agriculture community. In 2008, Alamance County was awarded its first grant from the North Carolina Agricultural Development and Farmland Trust Fund, Preservation Trust Fund, to permit protect productive farmland. We gather here today to talk about Preservation Alamance, a multifaceted program designed to assist landowners with tools to permanently protect their farms. Some of these tools include purchasing development rights and accepting donations of farmland, provide information on possible loans and grants available to farmers. Other aspects of the program include being able to accept tax deductible donations from individuals, corporations, and businesses. Other donations accepted could be farm and non-farm property in and outside of Alamance County. Future goals would include starting a farm incubator program where county-owned land can be leased to new or beginning farmers. Donated farms can be used to generate short or long-term revenues that would benefit the program by leasing land to local farmers or by timber grown for long-term investment. In closing, Preservation Alamance is a collection of tools and ideas to assist landowners to preserve their land forever. Thank you.
So you can kind of get an idea of how unique Preservation Alamance is as a program in the state of North Carolina. We're very grateful to the fact that the commissioners each year allocate funding to help preserve farms in Alamance County, but this program also adds some facets to that that include ways to use properties to sustain revenue coming into the program that would allow that preservation to be expanded beyond the county's allocation. And I do think it's also important and a unique facet to the program that Frank and Brad have reached out to real estate planners and local attorneys to encourage them to become involved with this program to help farm owners and landowners in our county understand how this program may benefit them. And you know, it's always a choice by a property owner of what they do with their property, whether it's a farm or any other type of property. And we want to help We want to make sure folks know about this option and that they fully understand it and are able to make a good decision about, is this the right program for me? So I think these are unique aspects to Preservation Alamance. So at this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce North Carolina Senator Gailey from right here in Alamance County. We're glad to have her with us today. She's been a strong supporter and advocate for local farmers, agriculture, and the Farmland Preservation Program. Senator Gailey served for a number of years as board chair of the Alamance County Commissioners and a commissioner, and she's currently serving as North Carolina Senator for District 24, and we're very glad to have her with us today. So please join me in welcoming Senator Gailey.
Thank you, Brian, and good morning, everybody. It is so good to see you all out this morning on this beautiful day, and thank you so much to the Teagues for hosting us. That was very gracious, and we truly appreciate that. There's no doubt that Alamance County firmly supports farmland preservation, regardless of political party. This is something we all agree on. Farms are vitally important. In a survey conducted for the new land development plan, 51% of respondents said that farmland and rural character was what they appreciated most about Alamance County, ahead of cost of living and access to parks, trails, rivers, and lakes. We made preserving agriculture one of our five strategic plan pillars on an equal plane as education, public health and safety, smart growth and development, and government accountability and resource management. 9.4% of the farmland in North Carolina is located in Alamance County, generating $41.7 million in products in 2017. This is not the last step in preserving farmland. There is much, much more work to be done. Our county has got to implement reasonable land use guardrails. Alamance is the only county between I-77 and I-95 for Virginia to South Carolina to have no zoning regulation outside the municipalities. Caswell County has some zoning around Hyco Lake. Randolph County, which many consider to be the most conservative county in the state, has countywide zoning. If you can put together land for a site big enough, if you've got enough money, deep enough pockets, you can do anything you want in Alamance County, whether it's a private landfill or asphalt plant. In 2000, there were about 130,800 people in Alamance County. Since then, we have added about 45,000 people, or 30%. That's almost like adding the total population of the city of Burlington in 19 years. No wonder our streets and roads are so crowded. Everywhere I go now, people are talking about how terrible traffic has gotten, especially in Mevin on Huffman Mill Road. And we can only imagine what's going to happen to the area of Pleasant Grove in the northern part of Mevin once the new Highway 119 bypass opens up. The number of houses in unincorporated areas grew by about 5,000 during that time period. Our rural areas are filling up with houses. From 2002 to 2017, 17,751 acres of farmland were lost in Alamance County. You can't hardly find a house or property to buy in Alamance County right now, much less rent. This is not a problem that is unique to Alamance County, as many other rural areas of North Carolina are facing declining farmland as well. However, Alamance County is unique between I-77 and I-95, Virginia to South Carolina, in not adopting the most basic measure to protect farmland, residential/agricultural zoning. I've heard farmers and other rural residents say something like, "I don't care if my neighbor does whatever he wants on his land as long as I can do what I want on mine." They resist with zoning regulations because it's an infringement on their personal freedom to do what they want with their own property. I understand and agree with this sentiment to a degree. However, it rests on the assumption that what your neighbor does is going to do will not tangibly impact your own peace and enjoyment of your property. That's a misguided assumption. What if your neighbor sells out to a subdivision because they're retiring from farming and their children don't want to farm? The people who move into that subdivision are not accustomed to country life. They don't join a local church. They don't even know what the volunteer fire department exists, what it does, and they sure don't join it. They get up in the morning, drive to work in Chapel Hill or Greensboro, come home and shut the garage door. It might be okay if that's all they did. However, on the weekends, they look around and see your farm. But to them, it's not a farm, it's like a private state park. They don't see waterways, they see four-wheeler trails. They don't see your pond, they see free fish. They don't know that the country custom is to call and ask permission to go over someone else's land or fish in their pond. If they did know that custom, they don't know who their neighbors are and have no idea who to call. You look up from washing dishes at your kitchen sink and see strangers from the subdivision next door fishing in your pond. You walk over to talk to them, but by the time you get there, they've seen you coming and they left. Or you talk to them, explain that they do not have permission to fish in your pond. They apologize, but then the next week they're back and maybe they brought some friends. Or they are rude to you, ugly, tell you to call the sheriff. And you know that by the time the sheriff gets there, they'll be long gone. Or you're awakened on Sunday morning at 7 a.m. by gunfire. What in the world, you think? You investigate and find that the people in the subdivision have set up a target range in their backyard without a berm or other protective measure, and they are shooting straight into your pasture at your cows. You call the sheriff, but the noise ordinance is forbidden by state law to interfere with private gun ranges. Even if a bullet hits your house, which I've heard has happened, there are evidentiary problems with proving who shot the round, and no one is ever held accountable. Or you go to mow your waterways and notice that they are all torn up. Someone has been riding their four-wheelers or dirt bikes on them, wreaking havoc. Or they have ridden in your field itself. No one can be held accountable, and you are powerless to stop them, short of fencing in the entire property. Or you walk through your woods and notice a new deer stand, maybe on the property line, but within the rifle shot of your house. Whoever is hunting clearly has no idea about safety or what they are doing. How are you going to figure out who that is? And how are you going to keep your family and home safe? Soon, it seems like all your free time is taken up dealing with the new neighbors and their encroachment on your peace of mind and use of your own property. And that's not even to mention or bring up all the complaints that come from the neighbors toward the farms with the smells and the sounds of a normal agricultural operation. We have got to take land use seriously in Alamance County. This farmland preservation program we are celebrating today is an important and very valued step, but is only one part of truly valuing agriculture and preserving the way of life that rural people treasure with all their hearts. A farm is a beautiful thing. It touches deep into our human experiences, people related to the land and to the weather. The poem, Corn Huskers, Autumn Movement, by Carl Sandburg, who was a North Carolina resident at the time of his death, and also a socialist, but we'll ignore that right now, says, and I quote, "I cried over beautiful things, knowing no beautiful thing lasts. The field of cornflower yellow is a scarf at the neck of the copper sunburned woman, the mother of the year, the taker of seeds. The northwest wind comes and the yellow is torn full of holes. New beautiful things come in the first spit of snow on the northwest wind. And the old things go, not one last." Farmland preservation is part of our effort to make the beautiful thing last. Those of us who own farms treasure them. It's like another child in our family that we love and care for. Farmland preservation is not only about the literal earth. It's about preserving a quality of life with peace and freedom within our own homes and property. The ultimate question is, how do we make the beautiful thing last?
The Soil and Water Group, Brad Bohr, to help preserve farms and to walk through the legal processes to do that. Kaylin has a real passion for land conservation, and we've all seen that. Staff have observed her passion for protecting farms, and we're very appreciative at Alamance County Government for all of her hard work and her collaboration. So at this time, I'd like to introduce Kaylin Kingsbury.
Thank you for the chance to be here today. I love farmland, and I love farmland preservation, and there's no county in all of the nine counties we work that does a better job of it than Alamance County. So it's really our privilege to be a partner. You might know about Piedmont Land Conservancy because we have, over the 30 years we've been around, our focus has changed. We focus on water quality protection. Sometimes we focus on urban space, sometimes wildlife habitat. But the most important thing to me is farmland preservation. And the good thing about farmland preservation is you actually hit all of those conservation values. If you have good farm practices, you protect water quality. If you protect wildlife habitat, and you protect the views that people appreciate when they get out of the city and they drive around in a beautiful place like this. So we got started in farmland preservation in the late 90s. Our first project was in Sutphin Mill, which is not too far from here. And a group of concerned farmers contacted Piedmont Land Conservancy to help prevent a proposed subdivision right in the heart of their farmland. And thankfully, we were able to help with that. So our roots go back a long way, and they go back a long way in Alamance County. So today, Alamance County launches a new program, yet another example of the foresight and leadership of the agricultural leaders of this county. They want to ensure that places like this farm are around forever. There is, as I've already said, no better county. Preserving farmland is important because we need safe, reliable sources of local food. We need the economic vitality that farming has always generated for our state. And farmland provides a sense of place that is central to our region's quality of life. Partnership and vision are the keys to making a program like Preservation Alamance work. First, someone has to dream big. Thank you, Frank. Then a lot of people have to work together to make that dream become a reality. So I'm very happy to represent Piedmont Land Conservancy, to be a part of this program, and I look forward to seeing how it all plays out. And I know it's going to be wonderful. Thank you.
And before I introduce our next speaker, I would just like to take a moment and recognize Commissioner Craig Turner. Commissioner Turner has joined us. We're glad to have him. So we have a good representation from the Alamance County Board of Commissioners, and we're glad to have you all here. I'd like to introduce Mr. Randy Lewis as our next speaker. Mr. Lewis operates the Ran Lou Dairy here in Alamance County. He's a local fifth-generation dairy farmer in the Eli Whitney community. And he's been a farmer for over 40 years, experienced all the challenges and difficulties and rewards that come with farming in today's climate. And he has managed to persevere in a very innovative farm at Ran Lou. He has worked closely with the Alamance County Soil and Water Office to preserve his farm, and it'll be good to hear from Mr. Randy Lewis at this time.
I reckon it's still morning. How y'all today? You ever had one of them days where everything you picked up just flew all to pieces? I've had that kind of morning, so I hope I don't mess this up too bad. First thing I done was dump a bunch of milk in the floor, and that's a bad way to start. I've known about the Farmland Preservation Program for a long time, since I'm sure back in the 90s, and never really thought much about it. I was sort of along the idea that it's my land, I'll do what with it I want to. If I want to set it out in the houses, I'll do it. I'll do whatever I have to do, but it's mine and I'll do it. And but as I have matured and hopefully gained a little insight, I really got to thinking about that's kind of narrow-minded and, in my opinion, in a way, a little bit selfish. I wound up having to buy the family farm for other reasons, but yet, I'm the fifth generation to make a living off that place. And I don't really have any heirs, so I really didn't have anybody to leave it to, and or I don't now anyway. So farmland preservation became very high on my list of things to do because it's the only way I could ensure that the farm stayed a farm. And to me, that was the most important thing about all of it. And I think as landowners move forward, depending on your situation, if you don't have heirs, if the land means as much to you as mine does to me, I think that's the key to it. I could certainly, that land's worth a whole lot to more, dollar and cent wise, is worth more to me sit out in houses than it is in anything I'll ever do. But that, you know, my saying is that once you plant a farm in houses, it don't grow much else for a long, long time. And that's a pretty permanent solution. So I decided to investigate that. I talked to Brad about it, and I also have to say that soil conservation, they're very good about helping you. If you really want to get into it, ask them. They'll point you in the right direction. They'll help you. They'll pull you. They'll get you in the right place, and they'll get you in touch with the right people. And after that, everything sort of went along, pretty seamlessly. I guess there's a lot of reasons. I can't say that the money didn't come in handy for what we got out of it, but that wasn't the reason that I did what I did. I did it because I wanted another generation. It may not be my descendants, but I'm working hard to try to figure out how I can set the farm up somehow so that young people could come in and maybe even just pay a small yearly rental or whatever and make all the money they want to. They'll never own the land, but they can certainly own the business. And buying land is why you can't farm anymore. There's no way on small acreages to buy the land and then pay it out. That's impossible. I've been paying on my place for 40 years and still working on it. So that might have some reflection on the dairy industry too. And that ought to tell you why when I was a kid, there were probably 80 grade A dairies in the county, maybe more than that, and now there's 5. And all of them are located in just about a straight line east and west from Eli Whitney to right past Sylvan School. That's just about where all the dairies left. So I think this new program that they're setting forward in the county, I've always been a little bit proud of the way that our county handled things like that. Pam was raised right across the street from me. We've known each other, I reckon, all our lives. And I was happy when she came to me and asked me about, what I thought about the farmland preservation and all of that. So I knew then somebody was taking it seriously, and I'm very proud of Alamance County for taking it all seriously because, with all the development around Mebane, if you really want to see some business and construction going on, go to Mebane. I deliver milk to a Lowe's store over there, and that's all that. Every time I drive in there, there's more cars and more houses. So I think that they're doing a really good job to try to, keep our rural heritage rural, at least, for those of us who still want to do it. And I think that's going to be very critical moving forward, is that we're going to have to, if the government, the county government or state government or whoever it is, doesn't help look after us, we're not going to be able to look after ourselves. It's just going to be too much. There's going to be too much money. We need help. And I'm very proud of Alamance County for doing what they can do to help us all get along better. And, they'll provide some natural space for us and a way of life for us that we grew up with. So anyway, that's my story. I hope y'all have a good day. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Mr. Lewis. That's very, very powerful to hear directly from someone that's taken the kind of actions that preserve property, preserve farms for our future here in Alamance County. At this time, we'd like to ask a few folks to come up to the stage and join us. Mr. Vaughn Willoughby, the Alamance County Farm Bureau President, Frank Bell of Bell Farms, and Chair Paisley of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners, and I think Brad Moore may also join us here on the stage. And Frank, I believe you have a guest with you.
My wife.
Your wife. All right.
60 years.
Yes.
Congratulations. Sympathy.
I guess I'll go. On behalf of the over 10,000 Farm Bureau member families in Alamance County, I bring you greetings. Alamance County Farm Bureau, we've been a long-standing partner with our county leadership when it comes to support for agriculture. The challenges that the farmers face now are so many and so diverse, it's an ever-changing climate. The one certainty is change. Sometimes it's good change, sometimes not so good. But in all things, this Alamance County Farm Bureau, we continue to be the voice for agriculture here in Alamance County. The pressure of continuing to farm is great, and the land use and the land planning are so important. Farmland preservation is so important and so vital to maintain land and agricultural productions. Farmers have many tools on the farm to help them perform the tasks at hand. Tilling and cultivation, planting and harvest, they rely on a variety of equipment and experience to get the job done. Today, we will add another tool to that toolbox. Preservation Alamance will help save and preserve farmland in a unique way. I'm proud to represent Alamance County Farm Bureau's contribution toward this effort. Our board has long sought for support for farmland preservation. Many people have worked long and hard to see this come to life, but I'd especially like to thank our county commissioners and our county manager for always being willing to listen to give us a seat at the table. And two key people, without their efforts, this would have never happened. Mr. Brad Moore and Mr. Frank Bell. We owe them a great debt of gratitude for everything they've done. So, on behalf of Alamance County Farm Bureau and our board of directors, I'm proud to present a check in the amount of $20,000 to Preservation Alamance. Thank you.
You gentlemen move over here a little bit, maybe we get a make sure we get to get a nice picture.
Somebody take a picture. Farm Bureau, we need a picture.
It's the largest check I've ever received.
Thank you, John.
And we thank you.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
For helping make this program a real success.
You're very welcome. Thank you. And actually, this is the real check.
It doesn't have my name on it.
Well, sorry.
What a great program. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Farm Bureau. Having been a member, I just shared this with Mr. Hastings a moment ago. I may be the oldest member of Farm Bureau anywhere around. In 1956, I became a member of Farm Bureau. At that time, it was because where I lived, I'm a transplant from Alabama. And it was in Alabama that I joined, and it was called Southern Farm Bureau. You remember that? So I go back a long ways. I'm happy this morning. This is a great day. Not because of some thoughts of people have inserted into a program, but for the opportunity, stop and realize for the moment. One of the greatest assets that this world has, that the Lord has given us, is land. He also gave us a mind and thoughts how to take care of that land. We have been stewards of this great land of ours all of our lives. As I said before, this society, you and I, are one of the smartest societies on the face of the earth. We can get things done. We got new ideas. We know how to implement them ideas. We have contacts. People that we know that an item that we don't know that they can help us with. All of this comes together in this program. It's been a burden on my heart for years. I served as a liaison for Farm Bureau with the county commissioners to try to get a budget approved that we could fund farmland preservation. Finally, this year, thanks to all of you commissioners and to Brian, we were placed as a line item in the budget. We're budgeted yearly, which is 10% of the reoccurring income for the county, which was generated by a present use value program that was implemented 10 years ago. People working together to accomplish great missions. That's what it's all about. But I suddenly realized after spending 10 years on the Board of Equalization that this money that the county was appropriated and the state in most cases matched was not enough to sustain land preservation. So in my heart and in my mind, I thought of everything that I've been involved in, and I've been in several venues in my lifetime. Things that people would want to help us do and were willing to help us do to pay for something to preserve the land that the Lord has given us to protect. We come up with this program. I'm grateful for the opportunity that has afforded me in my lifetime to be very successful. And I'm reminded of the statement that I make so many times, you can't outgive the Lord. It's a pleasure for Julia and I to be able to contribute $20,000 to this program to get it off the ground and help it be successful.
Y'all scoot over a little this way so you get a good clear shot of it.
You notice we're doing the shuffle. And we, with this program again, wish to thank the Bells. Thank you both.
Yes.
So much. It'll help this program tremendously.
Well, we are certainly.
I have one question. Are those checks going to drop in a drop box at a bank?
Sorry. Well, we are certainly grateful to Alamance County Farm Bureau and Frank and Julia Bell to help get Preservation Alamance up and running and going with the generous contributions that they've made. And beyond that, all the heartfelt work and relationship building that Farm Bureau and Frank have put into working with county government and our agricultural community leadership. As the county manager, I certainly appreciate it and appreciate both organizations very much. And at this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Sean Harding. We have Sean with us today. He's the North Carolina Farm Bureau President. We're glad to have him with us. Please come on up. Thank you.
Thank you, Brian. I am pleased, as everyone has said, to be out here on a beautiful day on a beautiful farm. You know, if you'll indulge in a minute, I want to talk to you a few minutes about who Farm Bureau is, and I think that will tie into this whole program. You know, North Carolina Farm Bureau is the second largest farm bureau in the nation, and we have over 600,000 members, and I say that quite a bit, very proud of it. But really, North Carolina Farm Bureau only has 100 members, because when you join a farm bureau, you join a county farm bureau, such as Alamance County Farm Bureau, and those 100 county farm bureaus are affiliated with this state organization. And that's what makes us so strong. The great leaders, the forefathers in this organization saw that this needed to be a grassroots organization, that policies that we develop and things that we do need to start on a local level, because we all know that's the best way. We can pass some great laws, Senator Gailey and Raleigh, and we can pass some great laws in Washington, but the best way is when local folks get together and figure out what's best for their county. And that's what we call grassroots. Our organization is really based upon that. You know, I'm very proud of Alamance County Farm Bureau and what they've done in this project, especially Vaughn Willoughby, President, all the board members that are here, I would thank them. And certainly Mr. Frank Bell, that's been mentioned many times, and the work that he's done to get this project going. So I applaud everyone here involved today. And the reason I applaud you is the cooperation that you see here. We all know, we watch the news, we see where our country is, and it's just frustrating when folks won't work together. And that's where I think Farm Bureau really starts with farmers. And what we do on the farm is we work together. We help each other out. And that's where we're at. And we're here to help each other out in any way possible. Cooperation is the key. You know, farmers, I'm one of them. We love our tractors, Commissioner Troxler. We love our tractors. And we love our barns, and there's some beautiful barns on this farm. But none of it compares to how we love our land. The land is where it all starts. And so I especially want to thank, when we talk about the county commissioners here, county manager, Brian, all the work that's been done, the cooperation here in this county, it's just amazing to see as I've gotten in this role and see so much gridlock in Raleigh and Washington where people will work together. It encourages me to be here today on this farm and to see this county saying, no, we understand the land's important and we're going to work to preserve farmland. So thank you again for what you're doing here in this county. We appreciate you so much, and thank you for a few minutes, Brian.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Sean. And at this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce the North Carolina Commissioner of Agriculture, Mr. Steve Troxler. Steve, from neighboring Guilford County, founder and owner of and operator of Troxler Farms, and been in production of tobacco, wheat, vegetables, and soybeans. And since taking office, Commissioner Troxler has focused on developing new markets for North Carolina farm products and to preserve working farms and protecting the state's food supply. And we're just really pleased to have Commissioner Troxler with us today. With no further ado, Mr. Troxler, welcome.
Thank you for being here. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I thank you for the opportunity to be here today, y'all. I'm actually at home when I'm in Alamance County. I live now in Guilford County in the Brown Summit community, but in 1755, there was one Troxler family that came up from Louisiana and settled along the Great Alamance Creek. So that's where we started. I have many people that are kinfolk in Alamance County today. In fact, I had a guy stop me one day when I was at a convenience store, and he told me the history of my family and told me that we were part of the crazy German settlement that was over on Alamance Creek. So I take great pride in being from the Piedmont of North Carolina, from starting in Alamance County. And great pride in representing the farm community in North Carolina. We at the department have always recognized how active Alamance County has been in farmland preservation. In fact, I would call Alamance County the state leader as far as doing what they could do to preserve farmland. I listened to Senator Gailey talk. The things she described, every farm in North Carolina is experiencing every day. It's much different than it was 20 years ago, 10 years ago. So it's pretty tough out there to just stay on the farm and own the farm. Why has North Carolina gained so much population? Look around you. It's pretty easy to see. But the very thing that makes us attractive is all this open space, the greenery, the growing crops, the farms. That's what's going away, and that's why we have got to put forth this effort to preserve these farms all across North Carolina. I have experienced urban encroachment in Brown Summit basically my whole life. In fact, when I bought my farm, it was already subdivided and was going to become a subdivision, even though I knew from living in that community, it was one of the best working farms that there was there. So I bought it. I paid too much for it, but I couldn't stand to see it go into a housing development, and it was the best thing that I've ever done. In 2000, I started to ride the state of North Carolina over, running for this position. And I saw the same thing all across North Carolina that I was experiencing in my community. And then in 2004, I did it again. And it had deteriorated even more in that four-year period as North Carolina began to get into this rapid growth state that we see now. So when I came into office, finally, one of my very biggest priorities was preserving farmland in North Carolina, and it still is today. We started by my long-term attorney and I sitting down and rewriting what was North Carolina farmland preservation law and really putting some teeth into it, trying to put some funding into it. And we created a separate division in the Department of Agriculture to deal with this, and it's the Agriculture Development and Farmland Preservation Trust Fund. It caught on pretty quickly. We got some funding and we went to work. But we have protected about 22,000 acres of farmland so far with easements in North Carolina. And that is a great thing to have happen. But look at the amount of farm and forest land that we have in North Carolina. Some 18 million acres of forest, 9 million acres of farmland. So you do the math at what we have really done. It's not nearly enough. There are things that prevent us from being able to do more, primarily funding for the trust fund. And I'm going to use a term here that is farmer vernacular from way back, but the Farmland Preservation Trust Fund has been sucking hind tit to other trust funds for a long time. Even though we all know how important this mission is, we have never been funded at the level that we need to be funded at to do what we need to do. And the reason I say that, if you look at the states in the United States that have robust farmland preservation programs, they're the ones that have already lost the farm. Let's start with New York. New York City found out that they were not going to have drinking water if they didn't preserve the farms in the northern part of New York and upstate New York. They've got a great problem. Pennsylvania, probably the best in the nation, they had lost the majority of their farms before they really got into it. So my goal has been, let's don't let North Carolina get to that position where we've already lost the farms before we start to really revere what these farms really are. And it's been talked about here this morning, what is a farm? I think most people get the idea that a farm is the place that we produce the food supply for the state, the nation, and the world. Yes, that's true. But look what else a farm is. We hear so much about climate change today. Well, a farm happens to be a green and growing place that sequesters carbon. You hear a lot about water quality. Well, with soil conservation and the things we do on our farms, we protect water quality on the farm.
Wildlife habitat, oh yeah, that's us. Everything that people really want a farm is, but it's also a business. And we've got to be able to make a living on this farm to be able to hold on to it and to pass it on to the next generation, which is so, so important. So farmland preservation can play into all of these things if we have the funding to do it. I am proud to have such an advocate as Senator Gailey in the Senate. In fact, this year, I haven't seen the conference report, but coming out of the Senate, it was the most robust funding for farmland preservation, about $50 million over 2 years. That's amazing. Now, we can do some major work with that. We've already got another 13,000 acres under contract when the funding comes about. So this is a great, great start if that funding comes through, but we've got to do it. The thing that I have run into in the legislature is the mindset that development is better than farms. The figures say something much differently. If you think about a farm and the infrastructure, especially at the county level, the local level, that a farm requires, not much. In fact, the national statistics show that if you have a farm paying taxes, the end result is it only takes about 70% of that tax to service the farm. And most of that is going to be what everybody gets, the roads, the schools, the fire departments. That's, you know, basically what a farm requires. But what we also know, if you take that farm out of production and you develop it, then the tax rate is going to have to go to about three times what it is at the farm level just to provide those services. When you move a family into North Carolina and take a farm out of production, it takes almost 2 acres of land to do that. Now, that's not saying it's a 2-acre lot or an acre lot, but it takes all the services that have to be provided. There are going to be shopping centers that come along with it, retail, all kinds of things that come along to provide these people with services that move in here. So think of the people moving in, think of the acres that it's going to take to service this population that we have moving into North Carolina. So I thank you so much today for being proactive to preserve farms in Alamance County. And it goes much beyond that. The United Nations says that we're going to have 80, 90, 100% more food by the year 2050 to feed the population of the world. And that may or may not be true. Pandemic certainly put a change in that. But we're going to have a lot more food. How in the world are we going to do it if we don't have the farms to farm? It's not going to happen. So this is another step in ensuring the strategic stability of North Carolina and the United States of America. If we can't feed ourselves, we're toast. I think everybody understands that concept. So what you're doing today is so, so important. We are $95.9 billion of economic impact in North Carolina. That's what agriculture is. I've had a goal for several years to be able to grow this industry to $100 billion. I think this is the year. From everything I'm seeing and hearing, I think we hit that $100 billion figure this year. So that's economic growth for North Carolina. We lead the state as an industry. We want to continue to lead the state as an industry, but we have got to have the natural resources to be able to do it. This is such a big step in the partnerships that we have to have in North Carolina to be successful. I can't commend you enough for what you're doing, for the local support. And I ask all of you to help educate the general public as to what a farm is and what that farm means to them, even though they don't live on that farm. The pandemic kind of showed some people that When that grocery shelf gets empty, panic sets in. We've seen it in snowstorms, ice storms. It's not a good feeling to go to buy food and the food not be there. But also contributing to the local food economy, kind of protects yourself against these supply chain disruptions that are out there. So all of this fits together very nicely for the future of North Carolina, the future of my children, your children, my grandchildren, and your grandchildren. That's what this is about. So thank you once again for the opportunity to be here. If you've been in Alamance County for quite some time, be careful what you say about me, because I'm probably your kin people. Thank you.
We have on the agenda for a few closing remarks by Mr. Frank Bell. So welcome Frank back to the stage to set us on with a good word.
Thank you, Commissioner Troxler, and all of you who have participated today in this historical event. This thing could not have happened without a lot of people's input. I would like to, and if I miss a name, raise your hand. I don't want to miss anyone. A year ago, I sat down with this gentleman here and shared a thought. He thought it was a good thought. We carried it to the county commissioners, and they thought it was a worthy thought. So we put together a task force to critique us, these ideas, and to come up with a program that we thought everybody, all of the population, would be willing to participate, because we recognized that we couldn't do it on our own. We needed participation. We also recognized that there are people out there that are farming and have farmed all of their life and don't have anybody to turn the farming over to. No line of succession. We tried to cover all the bases. I'd like to thank, and I've got a long list, I won't belabor this point, of people who's believed in this program and helped us and gave us thoughts and recommendations. First of all, Mr. Brian Haygood. Brian is responsible for working. We give all these people a hand when I'm finished. John Paisley, Chairman of the Commissioner's Board, Pam Thompson, Bill Lashley, there you are. Steve's not here, but we thank him. Craig Turner, where I see you come in, thank you. I'd like to thank Brad Moore and his staff for all the hard work that they've done putting this together and working on this thought for the last year. Kaylin Kingsbury, right here, she just spoke. Andrew Rollins, Andrew, there you are over here. She was at all of our meetings and had a lot of input and a lot of good advice. I'm still reminded of the statement you made that if you need some money, Andrew will find it. She knows where to go, and that's good. Thank you. Senator Gailey was on the original task force. Thank you for your participation. When we got started on this, we asked, and we went to a professional, and that was Pip Printing, and they helped us put together this brochure and did a beautiful job with it. By the way, some of those pictures that you see in that brochure, now don't hold it, the beginning of that against me. I didn't have nothing to do with that, the pictures. But some of those pictures came out of the book that we as Farm Bureau, when back 3 or 4 years ago, put together of agriculture in Alamance County. So a lot of those pictures were from there. Farm Bureau, I can't say anything other than Farm Bureau is the voice of agriculture. They are here in Alamance County. They are in the United States of America. So thank all of you who are members of Farm Bureau, board of Farm Bureau, and whatever. I'd like to go back in history just for a moment and thank some people that has brought us to this point. Rhett Davis, where are you? Raise your hand. Rhett goes back years ago. Thank you, Rhett. Paul Walker, where? He's been instrumental in bringing the preservation to this point back years ago. Mark Danley, raise your hand, Mark. Roger Cobb, raise your hand. These are people that we need to thank because they have brought us up to the point of where we are today. So, in closing, thank you for a good day and give all of these people who have participated a big hand. Thank you.
Well, this concludes our program today. Thank you all for attending and participating, and we'll look forward to reporting on success of Preservation Alamance as the program continues to roll out. So thank you all very much.